Please subscribe my channel and press the bell icon for getting latest updated video. Hello everyone. So let me continue with our yesterday's topic. In our yesterday's topic, we have discussed logical group instruction. So in that previous video, we have discussed logical AND or exclusive OR instructions and some few operation related with carry and accumulator. So specially we have performed operation on register, memory and data. So today, in today's session, we are going to discuss two more important instructions. So the name of instruction is compare instruction, and thereafter we are going to study rotate instruction. So how this instruction works, let me see. So first of all, we are going to discuss compare instruction, which is represented by CMP. So again, in this compare instruction, again we have to write down three sub instruction. In that, first instruction is compare with register, thereafter compare with memory, and the last one is compare with data. So guys, first of all, we are going to focus content with register. So as usual, we are going to write down the seven different points. So especially first point is general format. So our general format consists of content of A minus content of R. So the comparison is represented by minus sign. Thereafter, our next point is group. So we are discussing logical group instruction. So that's why in group column, I'm just writing down logical group. Thereafter, addressing mode. So I'm just write down in short form A dot M dot. So here in this case, operation is carried out on register. So that's why we directly say that register addressing mode. Now thereafter, bytes. So this instruction belongs to one byte instruction. And in case of flag, we can say that all flags may be affected. So in flag point, we just write down all flags may be affected. Now thereafter, our next point is what? Explanation. So when this instruction get executed by microprocessor, so content of A compares with content of register, and whenever it goes compare, then there are three following possibilities are there. So which are the three following possibilities? So maybe content of A is greater than content of R. Thereafter, content of A may be less than content of R. Or the third possibility or third scenario is what? Content of A equals to content of R. So guys, what happened in that case? So whenever we are going to write it down in this fashion, if we have these three different possibilities, then some flags are also get affected simultaneously. So when we write down content of A is greater than content of R, in that situation, my CY flag is 0. But when my first number is less than second number, in that scenario, my CY flag is equal to 1. And when both the numbers are same, in that situation, I am directly write down Z is equal to 1. That is, Z flag is affected. So these are the three different possible scenarios related with compare with register instruction. Okay, so this is all regarding about this type of instruction. Now we are going to discuss the next compare instruction, that is compare with memory. And one more thing guys, this instruction is very important, compare with register as well as compare with memory, because this instruction we are going to use in so many programs for comparing the given content with other content, especially largest number program we have to discuss, smallest number, then sum of series, thereafter count of occurrence. So in that, these types of program, we just need to use this compare instruction to check or to compare the given content with content of accumulator. Now guys, so there is a little bit change in this instruction. So instead of R, I'm just going to write down M. And in case of general format, content of A minus content of HL. Or we can say that M means memory. So in this case, content of A compares with content of memory. Thereafter, group is logical group instruction.
But here in this case, operation performed on memory. So that's why addressing mode is register indirect addressing mode. And in case of bytes column, you have to write down bytes 1 byte instruction. In case of flag, we may write down all flags may be affected. Now, whenever we are going to write down this type of instruction, again, according to our previous instruction, there are also same three different types of scenario. That is, we can write down content of HL. So R is replaced by content of HL. But remaining scenario remains unchanged. So how it would be? So content of A is greater than content of HL, then in that case my CY flag is equals to 0. When my content of A is less than content of HL, then in that scenario my content of carry is equals to 1. And if both the numbers are same, that is content of accumulator and memory, if both are same, then in that scenario we directly say that Z flag is equals to 1. So this is the scenario for memory. So there is one more compare instruction is there, and that name of that compare instruction is called CPI data. So this data always belongs to 8-bit number. So that's why I'm writing CPI data, and in bracket I have written 8-bit. Now in case of general format, there is a little bit change here. So what is that change? I will just show you that change. So here I am writing down content of A minus data, and in bracket I am just mentioning here 8-bit data. Now if we see the group point of view, it is logical group instruction. In case of addressing mode, we are going to perform operation on 8-bit immediate data. So that's why my addressing in front of addressing mode, I am just writing down immediate addressing mode. Immediate addressing mode. And here we are going to perform operation on 8-bit data. So that's why it is 2 bytes instruction. In case of flag, we may write down all flags may be affected. And when we are trying to compare this instruction, again there are 3 possibilities: greater than, less than, or maybe equal to. So here in this case, you have to compare with data, and data is always 8-bit, and the remaining situation will be same. Means if your content of accumulator is greater than data, carry flag is equal to 0. If it is less than data, then carry flag is equal to 1. And if both data as well as content of accumulators are same, then in that scenario we say that Z flag is equals to 1. So guys, in this way we have studied compare instruction. Now we are going to focus on our next very interesting topic, and the name of concept is rotate instruction. So guys, we have to discuss 4 different rotate instructions. So let me discuss one by one. So one more thing, once if you get the idea related with rotate instruction, so you can easily implement the rotate instruction for remaining 3 scenarios. So what are these 3 different scenarios? So in that, first rotate instruction is called RLC. So RLC means what? Rotate accumulator left without carry. RLC stands for what? Rotate accumulator left without carry. So in this type of addressing mode, operand is missing, means only opcode is given. So in that case, what we are going to write it down? So in case of addressing mode, we just write down implied oblique implicit addressing mode, and it is always 1 byte instruction. Okay, in case of flag, we may say that carry flag is affected, because we are just focusing on carry, means we are not including the carry bit in this instruction. Okay, so before writing the exact general format of this instruction, I will just in case of general format, I will just make it here blank, because to write down this general format, I will just first draw the diagram, and based on that diagram, we just try to write it down the general format. So first of all, what I'm trying to do, I will just draw the flag register diagram. So that's why from this diagram, it is more easy to understand the actual general format of this RLC instruction. So here I am writing down carry, and this is my accumulator, which is 8-bit. So this is my 8-bit accumulator. So here I'm just giving the labeling bit D0, D1, D2, D3, D4, D5, second last D6, and at the end D7. So what this instruction suggests me, rotate accumulator left without carry. So when we see that we are transferring or shifting the bit from left side with one digit, means what happened? Content of DY should be transferred to content of CY. See that content of D7 transfer to data content to CY, and the same thing means content of D7 you have to shift or move towards one bit left, that is called D0, and content of D0 old data we have to shift to D1, D1 carry forward to D2. In this way my last data, that is called D6, D6 content move to D7. So in this way, see the sequence or see the arrow position. So first of all, I have to transfer the data content of D7 to carry. Thereafter, content of D7 move towards D0. Thereafter, content of D0's old data shifted to D1. D1's old data shifted to D2. In this way, we just directly say that content of Dn shifted to Dn plus 1. So how can we write down the general format for this? So in general format, first of all, what we have done, D7 data we are going to move to the CY. So what to do? We just try to write it down from here. Content of D7 shifted to content of CY. Thereafter, D7 data we are going to D0. So here I am write down again, content of D7 shifted to content of D0. Thereafter, D0, D1, D2 to D3. So finally, I am just write it down, content of Dn shifted to content of Dn plus 1. So in this way, we are going to shifting one by one bit. But you have to just carefully observe that what I have did. So first of all, I have drawn this carry box. Then this is my flag register, or we can say that accumulator. So I have just represent all the 8 digits D0 to D7, and in this case we are not going to include in carry bit, so that's why we are shifting D7 data to carry, again D7 data to D0, D0 data to D1, D1 to D2. In this way we are going to shifting these bits through one digit towards its left position. Okay, and whenever we are going to start writing the general format, you just start from right to left, means first of all we are transferring the data from D7 to carry, then D7 to D0, D1 to D0 to D1. In this way we are transferring the data from Dn to Dn plus 1 position. Is that clear? So this is all about my general format. Then what is my next group? So group is logical group instruction. Addressing mode is implied / implicit addressing mode, bytes 1. And in that case, specially we are focusing on this carry. So that's why we may write down carry flag is affected. Okay, so this is the basic information or data related with this RLC instruction. Now, let me take the example, means how it gets work. So suppose my content of A is equal to 35H. And suppose my content of CY is equal to 1. So if I'm using this instruction RLC, then what will be its effect on this my data? So first of all, what I'm trying to do, this content of CY I'm going to store at here, and 35, that is I have to first of all convert that number into 4-bit binary form, and this 35 I have to store in this accumulator. So it becomes what? 0011 0101. So this is the binary conversion for 35. And if I'm following the actual scenario of general format, means content of D7 shifted to carry. So what is the data of D7? It is 0. So that data you have to shift towards carry. So my new answer is what? 0. The same thing means you have to shift the D7 data again it to D0. So it becomes 0. Now D0 data we have moved to D1. But what is my old data? 1. So that 1 data we have shifted to next position, so it becomes 1. Again this 0 gets shifted to next position, that's why 0, then this becomes 1, this becomes 0, this is 1, this is 1, and this is 0. So in this way, I will get the answer 0, 1, 1, 0, then 1, 0, 1, 0. So if I'll make group of 4, then it is nothing but 6, and 1, 0, 1, 0 is A. So my answer is 6AH, and my carry bit is 0. Are you getting what I'm trying to do this? So what I'm trying to do, I'm just shifting content of D7 to carry, D7 to D0, in this way Dn to Dn plus 1. So in this way, we are going to shifting the data from left position without carry. So what is my instruction? RLC, that is rotate accumulator left without carry. So once if you get this idea, this instruction clearly, then next instruction is what? Rotate accumulator left with carry. So for that purpose, there is a small change in this instruction. And what is that actually? That instruction is RAL, rotate accumulator left with carry. RAL represents what? Rotate accumulator left with carry. So if you see the previous instruction, in that case, we are not going to involve the content of carry. So there is a small little bit change, means content of D0 move to the content of CY. And in this case, we have to include content of CY. So what will be the change in this diagram? So instead of shifting D7 data to D0, we are shifting the data from carry to D0. See that, first of all, we have shifted the data from D7 to carry and carry to D0. Why? Because I am using RAL instruction, that is rotate accumulator left with carry. Okay, so there is a little bit change in my general format also. Content of CY arrow, content of D7 arrow, content of CY. Thereafter, here I am just writing down content of CY arrow D0, then D0 to D1, D1 to D2, finally Dn to Dn plus 1 position. So suppose if I am taking this kind of example and if I am going to implement the same situation, then my answer will be like this. So this is the answer because content of accumulator is shifted towards this, but it already contained 1, so that's why it gets override. And what will be my answer? So my answer is like this: 0110 0111. That is called 6B. So this is the answer in case of rotate accumulator left with carry. Now guys, our today's second last instruction of this group is rotate accumulator right without carry. So it is represented by the instruction RRC, rotate accumulator right without carry. So in that scenario, what happened? The sequence or the direction of this arrow gets changed. So in case of left, we use D7 to CY. Now in case of rotate accumulator right, we have to take the sequence from D0 to carry, D0 to D1. In this way, we are going to transferring the position of this data. So first of all, what I am trying to do, I will just rub this general format and I will just try to draw the fresh new diagram again. So that's why it is more and more easy and clear to you. So first of all, I am just draw the flag register, or you can say that accumulator. So actually both are different, accumulator and flag registers are different, but in case of accumulator, I am just making the 8 different boxes. Why? Because it is 8 bit is there. So this is 6, 7 and 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and finally it is 8. Now what I am trying to do, I will just showing the carry bit at this place because I have to shifting the data from right side. Okay, so again here I am just write it down: D0, D1, D2, D3, D4, D5, D6 and finally D7 is there. Okay, so what to do? I have to shift the data from D0 to carry, then D0 to D7, D7 to D6, D6 to D5, In this way, it gets shifted towards one beat, towards its right. Is that clear? So how can we write down its general format? First of all, I have transferred the data from D0 to carry. So that's why I'm writing like this. Content of D0 shifted to content of carry. Thereafter, D0 data shifted to beat D7. Then D7 data shifted to D6. And finally, we conclude that Dn data shifted to the position Dn minus 1. So this is called what? General format of this rotate instruction. Guys, one thing I want to clear you. You just able to write down the general format based on this diagram only. It is very difficult to learn directly the general format, because there might be a chance of making so many mistakes in that. Is that clear? So this is the scenario, or we can say that general format based on this diagram. And if we just try to write down the group, next point group, so it belongs to logical group instruction. Addressing mode is implied, implicit addressing mode. Thereafter, our next point is bytes. So bytes is one byte instruction. And in case of flag, we just write down only carry flag gets affected. Okay, so if I'm just trying to represent one example using this method, so content of A is equal to, suppose I'm taking 23H and my carry, that is content of CY, is equal to suppose 0, then what happened? What will be its effect on this instruction RRC? So first of all, what I'm trying to do, 23 is represented by this binary form 0010, then 0011 is the representation of 23, and carry becomes 0. Now, whenever I'm going to apply this RR instruction, first of all, according to my general format, D0 content shifted to CY. So D0 content is what? 1. So it gets shifted to carry. So that's why new data should be 1. And this 1 also get shifted to D7. Why? Because D0 content shifted to D7. So that's why it becomes 1. This old data gets shifted towards right. So that's why it is 0. This is 0. This is 1. 0. 0. Again 0. And this is 1. So in this way, finally, I will get the answer 1001001. So this is the answer. This is 9 and 1. So 91 is my answer. So how should we calculate this answer? So based on this general format. And how to write down this general format? So based on this diagram. So this instruction specially tells us how to shift the given bit data towards right by one bit position. Okay, so this is our third rotate instruction. Now guys, we are going to discuss our next instruction, rotate accumulator write with carry. So for that purpose, we have to write down the instruction like in this format, RAR. So we have to just write down RAR instruction. So we are just keeping this data, this general format as it is, but there is a little bit change. So instead of involving D0 in that case, we have to shift the data from carry to D7. Means content of D0 to carry, it will same as it is. But here you have to write down content of CY shifted to D7. So in this way, it will get changed and the remaining pattern will be same. If we take the same example, then see that what will be its effect. So here, content of D0 is 1, so it is shifted towards carry. But carry's old data 0 get shifted to D7 data, so it is overwrite by 0. And in this way, remaining bits are as it is same. So if we just try to find out the answer, so answer is 0001, again 0001, that is called 11. So this answer comes if I am going to apply RAR instruction. That is rotate accumulator write with carry. So in this way, guys, we have discussed four different instructions: rotate accumulator left without carry, rotate accumulator write with carry, and rotate accumulator left without carry, with carry, rotate accumulator write with carry, and without carry. So in this way, we have discussed all the four rotate instructions. So guys, if you have any difficulty, doubts regarding with this video, so guys, please write it down in my comment section. Okay, so thanks for watching this video. So we'll meet with some new data and new instructions with our next video. So thank you guys.